Transformers. Attention is all you need. Transformers beat state of the art. Transformers are better than anything else in NLP. Hi, are you tired hearing about transformer experiments and you wish there was higher architectural diversity when testing on benchmarks in machine learning, but especially in natural language processing? Then congratulations, you found the right video for you, because today we are discussing this paper that asks a very natural and interesting question. Are pre-trained convolutional models better than pre-trained transformers? From this paper, we will find out how CNN-based models, whatever that might mean, we'll see in a bit. So, CNN-based models benefiting from the same amount of pre-training as transformers were found to be competitive or even outperforming transformers in certain experiments. Or at least that's what the abstract of the paper says. Ms. Coffee Bean thinks that in this video you will learn something about transformers versus CNNs, but you will also learn something about the importance of framing in papers. Ms. Coffee Bean, what even makes transformers so successful? What do they have that other architectures don't? Well, many things. First, they are efficient, because things that an RNN computed sequentially, transformers compute in parallel, enabling large training scales and faster computations on larger datasets than LSTMs, for example. Second, and as a consequence, the pre-train and fine-tuning paradigm came into fashion in NLP, because with the transformer being more efficient, pre-training became a thing with language models on larger and larger amounts of text. You know, we're talking about BERT, Roberta, T5, the GPT family, and so on. Third, the transformers enable contextual representations through self-attention. Miss Coffee Bean, I must stop you there on the contextual bit. Contextual representations in pre-trained language models were not a first with transformers. For example, Elmo and Covey enabled this already with LSTMs. And also, pre-training and fine-tuning was not invented with transformers. Pre-training was not that big of a thing in NLP, but certainly in computer vision, where basically every CNN backbone was pre-trained on image. So, this paper now asks, what if convolutional architectures can actually perform on par with transformers, but this hypothesis was so far mostly neglected and untested since transformers took all the attention, pun acknowledged but not really intended. What if both the pre-training and the architectural advances happened simultaneously with the transformer, but that this doesn't mean that these two factors shouldn't be separated and analyzed independently? And this what if question, this possibility, is what this paper aims to answer by just trying it out with CNNs. Or that's what the paper says. There are recent works showcasing CNNs on sequence-to-sequence modeling too, but this study is the first, Ms. Coffee Bean, did you check, to be more comprehensively structured on a range of tasks and focuses on the pre-train and fine-tune paradigm. Or this is what the paper says. Ms. Coffee Bean, why do you keep saying this? Well, why the focus on CNNs? The paper says it because their window is smaller than for usual self-attention, you know, which was spanning all tokens. Therefore, they are faster to compute, not suffering from quadratic time and memory complexity. It's only linear. Furthermore, they operate locally and do not need this extra construct of positional encodings forced into the architecture. But this also means that the global context cannot be captured by one layer only. In a convolutional network, it is the succession of layers that increases the context window or the field of view, to use a computer vision term. For example, for a kernel of the size of 2 tokens, if the third token would be radioactive, let's say, in yellow, it would mean that after one layer, the first token doesn't include information from the third token, but only from itself and the second token. But after the next layer, it also contains information from the third token. Okay, this is a very interesting striding choice, Miss Coffee Bean. Okay, but if we're going to replace things with convolutions, what about attention making the transformer so powerful? Well, does it really? There have been papers recently showing that replacing learned attention matrices with random matrices does not hurt much, and we do not even want to start about papers replacing the self-attention layer with an MLP layer or even with a Fourier transform. Okay, so to recapitulate the opponents of today's match, the CNN versus the transformer, or this is what the paper says. Let's go. In the right ring corner, we have the transformer, the well-known champion, the state-of-the-art in NLP beating T5. Well, at least a T5 replica, which is pre-trained on the colossal cleaned common crawl corpus with span-based masking as a pre-training objective, which in English means that the random spans composed of more words are masked and the model must fill in the blanks. Then this model is further fine-tuned on diverse downstream tasks comprising toxicity detection, sentiment or news or question classification, semantic parsing. In the left corner we have the challenger, a sequence-to-sequence CNN model, which is basically a transformer architecture but where self-attention is replaced with convolutional blocks. In other words, this paper is perhaps framed as analyzing what gains the pre-train and fine-tune paradigm promises for CNNs versus transformers, but it is actually, we replace the self-attention with insert here, X, and this X happens to be convolutions. Wow. I do not know about you, but Miss Coffee Bean thought that this paper was something different than the MLP and FNet paper we have seen lately. But in hindsight, it is exactly the same paper pattern, replacing the self-attention layer with something else, this time with convolutions. It's all about the framing. Therefore, keep in mind that this paper should not be interpreted as what would have happened if the transformer did not ever come into existence in NLP and a completely different architecture would have emerged, but rather as what would happen if one layer in the transformer would be not self-attentive but convolutional, where all the rest in the transformer is kept the same. Miss Coffee Bean really believed that this paper disentangles the transformer architecture and the pre-trained and fine-tuned paradigm. This paper does not really disentangle much. Okay, rant over, we will discuss this just a little bit more at the end of the video. So, self-attention is replaced with convolutions in three configurations: lightweight, dilated, or dynamic convolutions. In short, these words mean the following. A lightweight convolution is when convolution parameters are shared every other channel. Dilated means that every other pixel counts when computing the results of the operation, and dynamic convolutions are lightweight convolutions but with learnable position-specific kernels. Yay. So this CNN, in quotes, model is trained and fine-tuned on the same data as its opponent with the same masked span prediction objective. And now we come to the interesting part. The authors let the two opponents compete, and well, the results on the tasks show that there is no clear winner here. There are cases where transformers are better, but also many cases where convolutional variant is better, so this means that convolutions also benefit from pre-training. That's acknowledged. That's even expected, because even the convolutional architecture here is almost a transformer. The authors highlight that convolutions are not the best choice in tasks that need cross-attention between two or more sequences, like in natural language inference, where you must predict the relation between two sentences. In this case, the cross-attention inductive bias is desirable. On the bright side, experiments confirm the theoretical consideration saying that convolutions are faster, the scaling is linear in sequence length, and CNNs are in general more efficient in the number of floating point operations than transformers. In conclusion, the authors themselves say that there is no clear winner in this battle. What Miss Coffee Bean likes about this paper is that it shows that there is some architectural tuning that might be beneficial on certain tasks. The point of discussion for Miss Coffee Bean is on the last point made in the paper about disentangling pre-training and architectural advances. The authors claim that they showed that convolutional-based architectures can also benefit from pre-training. And this is where Ms. Coffee Bean disagrees. So here it is, she puts her point up for debate. She might be wrong after all. To understand what CNN-based architecture means here, it also comes down to understanding what transformer architecture means in the first place. Is self-attention something of an essence to transformers? Is a transformer not a transformer anymore if one replaces the self-attention with something else, be it an MLP, a Fourier transform or a convolution? Is it still a transformer without its residual connections or normalization layers? When is a transformer not a transformer anymore? Well, this is a hard question to ask for anything. Like, when is Ms. Coffee Bean not Ms. Coffee Bean anymore? If you remove the arms or the legs or the eyes? This is a hard philosophical question.
Essentially.
For Ms. Coffee Bean, self-attention is not that much of an essence to the transformer, but it is the exact flow and parallelism of information where one starts with a sequence or rather a set of tokens, then has an aggregating or mixing layer for all the tokens to produce new tokens. These newly produced tokens are then processed individually and not together. And replacing the self-attention layer with a convolutional one does not make the architecture immediately a CNN. It is perhaps a CNN-based transformer. But if we would name it such, then a transformer is an attention-based transformer. What do you think? What are you allowed to remove from the transformer to still make it a transformer? Are you happy with the framing of this paper where they say that CNNs are compared with transformers? Or do you think that transformers with convolutional layers are still transformers? And its terminology, how should the naming of these things work anyway? And with all these questions, Ms. Coffee Bean leaves us.